Hello students, welcome back to the math class. In our last class, we have discussed some concepts about the patterns. Today, we will go through some more concepts of patterns. Today, we will start our discussion with magic hexagons. As you can see in your book, there are some patterns of numbers in hexagons. Each side has two circles and a box. Now, the hexagon goes like 7, 70, 10, 20, 2, 26, 13, 65, 5, 70, 14 and 98. So, look at the number 65 in the box, which are the circles next to it. Yes, exactly. These are 5 and 13. So, what is the product of 5 and 13? 5 13 jar or 13 5 jar, it is 65. So, can you see how the rule works? So, let us think about number 70. So, the numbers which are around it are 7 and 10. So, what is the product of 7 and 10? Yes, it is 70. That means, the rule says that the product of the numbers in circle in pair is given by the square that resides within the pair of the numbers. For example, let us think about 26. It is in a square, so the circles around the square having 26, they are having the numbers 13 and 2. So, 13 into 2, 26, 13 into 5, 65, 14 into 5, 70, 14 into 7, 98 and so on. Now, let us use the same rule to fill the hexagons. Those are given in the book. Okay? So, students, as it is given in your book, there are two hexagons and some blanks are there. So, we need to fill those blanks. So, what the rule says? We need to multiply the numbers in the circle and the product should be written in the square which is within the two circles. That means, for example, in case of the hexagon, that is in the bit number A, you can clearly see a blank is there between the circles having numbers 11 and 9. So, 11 9s are 99. We need to fill the square with the number 99. Same way, 11 and 6 are the circles and there is a square which is blank. So, it should be filled with the product of 11 and 6. 11 6s are 66. Okay. Hope you can do it by yourself now. You can go to the hexagon which is in the bit number B and try it out. Hopefully, you can solve it by yourself. Okay. And you can also make your own magic hexagons and try to fill the blanks using the same pattern. Okay. So, now, let us discuss about numbers and numbers. As it's given in your book, there are some geometrical shapes and some numbers are written within. Just concentrate on the first pattern. There is a star, there is a pentagon and there is a square and some numbers are written within. Those are 24, 19 and 37. And they all are added. And the sum is equal to 37 plus 24 plus 19. What does it mean? It means that the sequence of number while addition doesn't matter. We can follow any of the sequence and we will get the same result. In case the second sequence, it is 215 plus 120 plus 600. Which is sum up to 600 plus 215 plus 120. You just think about it. We have arranged the patterns in different way in both the sides of the equal sign. That means left hand side and the right hand side. You can add both the side and you will find that you will have the same result both the side of the equal sign. That means the sum that will be there in the left hand side will be exactly equal to the sum that will be in the right hand side. Now, try to fill the blank spaces that is given in the book. Let me do the first one for you. There is a number 14 and plus sign is there, but we have two blanks and it is equal to 34 plus 14 plus 20. Now, can you think what should be there in the left hand side exactly? Now, you can shift or you can draw the same geometrical shapes, those are in the right hand side, that is 34 in a square and 20 in a circle. You can put them after 14 in the left hand side and you will find that the sum in the left hand side will be exactly equal to the sum in the right hand side. Now, I think you can do all the other sums by yourself. You can fill the blanks in the bit B, C, D and you can find that left hand side and right hand side will give the same number as the sum. Okay? Students, now look at your book. There is a sequence of multiplication, that is 48 into 13 is equal to 13 into 48. Check if it is true or not. Yes, it is exactly equal. The same rule goes with multiplication. 48 into 13 is equal to 13 into 48. That means sequence of writing the numbers in case of multiplication also does not matter. It does not hamper the result of the product. We can find out the product in both left hand side and right hand side and we will find that the product is exactly equal in both sides. Let us take another example. I am going for smaller numbers. Let us do 2 into 3 into 4. That is equal to 2, 3 is 6, 6, 4 is 24. Now, I am going to change the sequence of the numbers. Let me write 3 into 2 into 4. That is equal to 3, 2 is 6, 4 is 24. Again, let me change the sequence another way. 4 into 3 into 2. That is equal to 4, 3 is 12 into 2, 24. So, students, I have already explained the result of the product is exactly same in each sequence. So, sequence of numbers does not matter in case of multiplication as well. Hope you have understood this. So, students, from this, we have come to the conclusion that left, right, same to same. Okay. So, whether it is addition or it is multiplication, the left hand side and right hand side will give us the same result if we are using same numbers. Okay. So, we can have a pattern like this. A plus B is equal to B plus A. Or A into B is equal to B into A. Now, you can substitute any number in place of A and B and you will find that they will give the same result both the sides. This is our left hand side and this is our right hand side. So, in each case, you will get the same result. Now, let us take an example for addition. See, 2 plus 3 is equal to 3 plus 2. In this case, A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, 3 plus 2 is also equal to 5. This is for A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3. Same way, 2 into 3 is equal to 3 into 2. 2 into 3 is equal to 6. 3 into 2 is equal to 6. That means for A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3, A into B is equal to B into A. Okay? So, students, let us discuss about another concept, that is left, right, same to same. Students, just see the picture that is given in your book. The picture says, or it describes a conversation between a man and a woman. So, let us go through the conversation. The lady says, can you see something special about 121? The man says, what? It's just a number. And he gets reply, see, it is the same forward as well as backward. Now the man realizes and he says, oh yes, it is 121 from right to left also. So left, right, same to same. Let us now discuss this in a better way. Okay? So students, as it is given in a book, take a number say 43. Now turn it back to front. It gives us 34. Then add them together and it gives 77. Yes, 77 is one such special number. There are many such numbers. We have just reversed the number by writing it back to front, and when we added the number that is reversed with the original number, we get such a number that has same digit in the tens place as well as its ones place. There are some other numbers. Let us take another number, that is 48. When I reverse it, I get 84. Let's add this. 8 plus 4, 12. 2 carry 1. 8 plus 4, 12 plus 1, 13. So it gives me 132. Is this a special number? No. Why not? Because when I go from left to right, I have 1, 3, 2. But when I go from right to left, I get 2, 3, 1. So it gives me different numbers. But another thing, when I add these numbers, that is 132 and 231, when I add this, I get 363. See, 363 is a special number because it is same from left to right as well as from right to left. Yay! We have found another special number by going through some process. Okay? So, isn't it great? So, students, from this, we come to know that to get special numbers, we sometimes need more steps. In the first case, when we have 43 and 34, in the first step itself, I get 77, that is a special number by adding the numbers. But in this case, in the second case, we have to follow some more steps to get to the special number 363. Okay? So students, now you try and change the numbers those are given in your book and find out the special numbers. So the numbers are 28, 132, 273. Let us discuss bit A first. Okay? 28. 28, when it is reversed, It gives 82. Let us add 8 plus 2, 10. 0, carry 1. 8 plus 2, 10. 10 plus 1, 11. It is not a special number. So, let us reverse it to get 0, 1, 1. Let us add 1, 2, 1. Yay! Now, I get a special number 121, that is same from left to right and from right to left as well. Okay? Now, students, you do bit number B and C by yourself. It's fun, isn't it? Students, now let's use words in a special way. Okay? So, there are some words. No lemons, no melon. Step not on pets. So, did you notice that it reads the same from both sides, right to left and left to right? Just concentrate. No lemons. Okay? No lemons. Okay? No lemons. And no melon. Step not on pets. Okay, see. So, here what happens when I go from left to right, I have STEPNOT. Okay, fine. So, again from this side, STEPNOTONPETS. The reverse order, the letters are arranged in the same way from right to left. When I concentrate on the first one, see, NOLEMONSNOMELON. When you concentrate, just do it by yourself. Look into the book. Find out whether there is the same sequence. You will find that from right to left as well, the letters are arranged in the same sequence. See, N, O, L, E, M, O, N and S in the middle. So, these are following the same sequence in both ways, from left to right as well as from right to left. Okay? Students, let us do some magic with calendar. That is your calendar magic. Look at the calendar that is given in your book. And there is a 3 into 3 box. It is marked on the calendar. And the numbers are 3, 4, 5, 10, 11, 12, 17, 18, 19. So, these are 9 dates which are marked inside a square. So, let us add them. 3 plus 4, 7 plus 5, 12. 10 plus 11, 21 plus 12, 33. 17 plus 18, 35. 45 plus 9, that is 54. 4 plus 3, 7 plus 2, 9. 5 plus 3, 8 plus 1, 99. So, the sum is 99. So, let us see whether we can get into this sum in a faster way. Let's look into it. So, students, the center of the 3 into 3 box is 11. So, here is the solution for you. The magic one. Yes, 11 into 9 gives us 99. So this is the magic. You need not to add all these numbers. So in a calendar, if you get 9 numbers which is in a square, so the sum of all these numbers is nothing but the product of the middle number with 9. So let us do another set of numbers. Okay, so students, let us do the magic with another set of number. So as per the calendar that is given in your book, let me take set of 9 numbers from the left. Those are 1, 2, 3, 8, 9, 10, and 15, 16, 17. So let us add all these numbers. 3 plus 2, 5 plus 1, 6 plus 19 plus 8, 27 plus 15 plus 16, 31 plus 17, that is 48. 8 plus 7, 15 plus 6, 21. 4 plus 2, 6 plus 2, 8. 81. So, as we have already discussed, the number at the center is 9. So, when I multiply 9 with it, I get 81. So, it is true for any set of square numbers. Okay? Students, let us now discuss some more number patterns. As given in a book, take any number. Now multiply it by 2, 3, 4 and so on at every step. Also add 3 to it at each step. Look at the difference in the answer. Is it the same at every step? Let us find out. In the first row, it is 12 into 2 plus 3, that is 27. Second row, 12 into 3 plus 3, 39. Row number 3. 12 into 4 plus 3, that is 51. Now let us concentrate on the results. Row 1 gives 27. Row 2, 39. And row 3, it is 51. So let us subtract 27 from 39. 39 minus 27 is equal to 12. 51 minus 39 is also 12. That means the sequence or the pattern goes with the increment of the number itself, that is 12. We have started with 12, okay, and the sum or the result of the sequence or the pattern, it goes with an increment of 12. Okay, 27 increased by 12 gives us 39, which is increased by 12 gives us 51, and so on. Okay, now you can try doing it with some other numbers and also take a different number to add at each step. Just remember, you have to start the multiplication with 2. And you can go ahead as 2, 3, 4 and so on. So let us take another example. Let us go with number 10. Okay. So 10 into 2. Let us add, in this case, suppose 5. It is 25. 10 into 3 plus 5, 35. 10 into 4 plus 5. 45, and we can go so on. So what is the difference? 35 minus 25 is equal to 10. 45 minus 35 is equal to 10, which is nothing but the number which we have taken initially. Okay, isn't it a magic? So students, with this we have come to the end of this session. In this session we have discussed about different patterns and the rules they follow. We have also done some of the activities. So students, go through the concepts again, and in the next session we are going to learn some more concepts about the patterns. Till then, keep practicing, keep enjoying life, and keep smiling. Thank you.